why am I a transhumanist? For starters, I've always been a transhumanist. I've always had a distinctive urge, that distinctive instinct to want more. I was, however, cursed with imagination, so normal life, average baseline life, didn't appeal to me much, as you can see. I always wanted to cross certain boundaries that were unimaginable for typical people. So for me, the whole transhuman thing is an instinctive thing. It's an inborn thing. It's a very strong predisposition that dated back to my early youth even. Of course, reading science fiction for sure as hell helped. Larry Niven had a certain transhumanist ring, and as a young child I read Larry Niven. But everything subsequent just hammered in that message. Blade Runner, Alien, the list goes on. I find this world as it is, it's fun. I can live with this. It needs, like the cliche from William Gibson, it's, I'm considerably drug efficient. But I can handle this. It's been worse in my past. It wasn't always easy, but right now things are pretty good. But we could be so much more as a species, as a life form, as an intelligence, as a collective. We could easily make this planet into a paradise, easily. And that's almost unimaginable. We could make everyone reach a level of fulfillment and achievement that is unimaginable. Look back at like 400, 500 years ago, how people lived, and look at the progress we've made since then. Now extend that progress several times, and you end up with an amount of meaning and paradise and just gregariousness and adventure, it's fairly believable. For me, the big inspiration, the big examples for what I expect from transhumanism, the transhuman future, are novels like Seismatrix. I know Bruce Sterling, it's not his favorite novel, but Seismatrix definitely, Vacuum Flowers, the Mars series, Red Mars, of course, this, the other one from Kim Stanley Robinson, 2134. Look at the movie Wanderers on YouTube. That's my image. I love Elon Musk. I don't like some of his politics, but I love the vision of getting off this planet and not becoming a community of countries, a quarrelsome, claustrophobically constrained countries with too much humans clustered on a small planet. No, I think that 1.5 centuries from now, most people that are alive today will still be alive. Think about that. That means you will still be alive. And a ticket off planet will be along the lines of the movie Ad Astra. So affordable if you put your back into it. And that means colonizing other planets. Literally, physically traveling with Dunkin' Donuts, sorry for the, with all the amenities of modern life, all the luxuries, all the conveniences, all the affordances, and many more affordances as well. Traveling off planet, going to Mars, to the asteroids, to Ceres, to the moon, all the way to the outer solar system, if that's your thing. But not like this, of course. I'm happy with the progress I've made, very happy, but I want more. And I think it's fair to want more. I think it's a central tenet of the human spirit, one that should not be embellished or diminished or deleted or overcome, is to aspire, and not just to destructive zero-sum things, but to be beautiful, to be wonderful, to be full of grace, to be full of adventure, to be full of wonderment. And that's why I'm a transhumanist. Because I have too much bleep imagination. I can see things, I can imagine things, I can visualize things that are so of the scale and so wondrous. And I feel this certainty about it, that they are within reach. Stones a throw away. Blah, blah, blah. These arms, why don't I have four? These eyes, why can't I see into the deep infrared? These ears, just normal ears, functional normal ears would be great, because I know sometimes I don't hear a thing when I'm at the party. Just fix them, please. This body, make it functionally 23 again, and then so. That's my dream. And what do I do with that? Just wait, like most people, like a lot of transhumanists, that they say, yeah, I am busy doing projects, and I'm busy doing the startup, and I'm doing this, and I'm doing that. It's just grossy work at this stage. There's the few that do the real heavy lifting. You know who you are. I know you. Hi, Aubrey. hi, Ben. Hi, David. Hi, Amanda. You're all doing a lot, but most transhumanists, like me, we just have to wait and see what happens. And we can just proselytize. We can just argue a case. We can just show our enthusiasm. But I think it is coming. This leap is coming. It's happening. On that note, 2020 is coming. I wish you all a wonderful New Year's party. I wish you all many conquests of the positive kind. I wish you all to have so much more fun in the next decade than you had in the previous ones. And I wish I get my wish. Not for me, just for me, but also for you. Because my wish is bleep inclusive. Completely and utterly, collectively inclusive. Because if I get my wish, trust me, everyone on this planet will be a bleep load happier. Yeah. Does that make sense? I think it does. That's why I'm a transhumanist. Oh, well. Titty shots. Bye-bye.